All right, now it's time to log into our big IP appliance and go ahead and do some basic config. So here we are connected to 192.168.121.1 because that's the IP address of the management interface. Put in admin as the username, and the password is going to be whatever we set in the last nugget when we went ahead and configured a password. So I'm going to put that in, and there it goes. I need to put that password in again because it's going to make me change it again. Okay, and then come down here and put in a new password and confirm that. Super. And go ahead and click save. All right, password changed successfully is what it's showing here. So now I'm going to log in with my new password, admin, and the new password. Excellent. Say log in. And super. Now we are here, and let's look at this for a minute. Now at the very top, we've got a message here. It says no license exists for this device. So that means we need to put a license in, and we're going to do that. So the first thing we're going to do, we are in the welcome setup utility. So we're going to go through this setup utility. But before that, I want you to take a look at the top left here. We have a host name, BigIP1. We got our IP address. We have a date and time up here, the user that's logged in, and the role of the user. Pretty good. That's some information you should be familiar with if you ever need to reference it. So let's go ahead and click next on the setup utility. There we go. Super. Now, it says license, not activated. Let's go ahead and activate a license. Let's get our trial license. So here we go. It's now asking for our registration key. So I'm going to jump back over to the F5 website. There we go, where we've got our license key. So I'm going to grab that first one for our Big IP Virtual Edition. I'm going to grab that. Super. I'm going to go back over to my Big IP, and I'm going to paste that in just like that. Super. And you can add additional keys if you'd like to, but we're not going to do that. For your activation method, we're going to do automatic, requires outbound connectivity, which is fine. It means it's going to reach out to F5 and make sure everything's okay. So your outbound interface, need to make sure this is set to our management interface. That's how we have it configured in the lab. All right. And license comparison, we're not going to do that for now. We're just going to say next. So right now it's receiving config data from your device, communicating out to F5. So we're going to give that a minute to go ahead and do its communications. All right, there it went. It communicated out. Now we have to accept the EULA. So let's go ahead and do that. Accept. It's going to go ahead and communicate outbound again. And now it says our Big IP system configuration has changed. So what's happening is it's going to go ahead and do a utility update. So we're going to let that do that. And then we'll be back when that finishes. All right, it has finished with that. So we can go ahead and click on continue. And we'll continue with our setup utility. And this is our resource provisioning page. We see resource provisioning up here. And we can see there's a whole bunch of stuff in here. And right now we're looking at our local traffic manager, or LTM. Here's our management. The provisioning is set to small. Down here you can set to dedicated, nominal, and minimum. So we're going to leave that at nominal for now. And we're not using these others just yet. So we're going to leave all of that just like it is. And we're going to go ahead and click on next. Super. Now, once that goes ahead and finishes that, it's taking us to the next page. And this is dealing with our certificates. So the certificate name is server.crt. Gives you your local host and gives you some information about your certificates. We don't need to do anything here. So we'll click next. And here we have some general settings. So we see the IP information that we set up earlier. This is our management information because this is our management config IPv4. That's exactly what that is. And our IPv6 is set to DHCP. That's fine. We should go ahead and give it a host name. So let's do that. Let's call this bigip1.f5lab.int for internal. There we go. Perfect. That's just our local host name. The host IP address, it says use management port IP address. We're going to leave that. For your time zone, go ahead and select your time zone. So I need to find mine right there. That's the closest one. Super. There we go. Now for your user administration, SSH access is enabled. You can actually disable login for the root account if you'd like to. Now for SSH IP allow, right now it's set to all IP addresses, but you can select a specific range. We're going to leave it at all IP addresses because this is a lab. And then disable external monitors. I'm not going to deal with that right now. So we're going to go ahead and say next. I'm going to let that load up. And, oh, I forgot the root account. You do have to set the root account password. So let's go ahead and put in our password for that. And I'm just using the same password I used for my web login. There we go. Super. Now we'll click next. Now we have two areas here. Your standard network configuration appear towards the top, and then down here, advanced network configuration. We're going to go with the standard network configuration at this point, so I'm going to click next here. So for redundancies, your cold sync and high availability, we're not dealing with that right now, so just go ahead and click next, because we're just doing a basic setup at this point to get up and running. So internal network configuration, this is our inside, our internal. So what is that going to be? We need to bring up our topology here. So our internal is 10.10.101.11, and the floating is 10.10.101.13. So 11 and 13, 10.10.101. So let's go here. For our internal is 10.10.101.11. Netmask is just class C, 255.255.255.0. Port lockdown, we're not going to deal with, but our floating was 10.10.101.13. Super. Now that port lockdown, if we look at it, you can say allow none for nobody connect to it, or allow 443 only. This is for management access connecting in. There we go. Internal VLAN configurations. We've talked about VLANs, and we can put a VLAN ID if we want to. Now, here is where we can set it to auto, which is just going to go ahead and automatically select a VLAN ID to use. And I'm going to leave this at auto because we're not using VLANs on our internal or external networks here. VLAN interface, though, I need to select an interface. Now, if we go back to our topology, we look at internal, we're using interface 1.2. So let's change that. All right, we're going to go interface 1.2. The tagging, we're going to go untagged because we're not tagging any VLANs because we're not using VLANs in this lab. So if you were going to tag, though, you could go ahead and do that, but we're not. So now I'm going to hit add, and that's basically just going to add that interface in here, that 1.2. So super. And now we're going to click next because we have just configured our internal interface. So if I say next, it's going to go ahead and update that information. And now we're at our external network configuration. So under our IP address, we need to put that in. And what is that going to be? Let's go take a look. On our external, that's up top here, 172.16.101.11 and 13 is our floating, so 11, and it's interface 1.1. So 172.16.101. So let's go back over here. Let's go to 172.16.101.11. Our floating is, let's go ahead and put our floating, 172.16.101.13. Excellent. Our netmask is a default class C. And our gateway, we're not going to have one because we're not providing internet access through our WAN interface. So this, is, again, is only going to be there so we can connect to it with our test box to try to access services on the internal side of our F5. So port lockdown, we're not going to deal with that. A VLAN name is external. Tag, we'll leave to auto. Interface was, again, 1.1. If I jump back real quick, that's because here on our topology, our interface is 1.1. Super. And tagging is untagged. We're not going to tag. We're not using VLANs here. I'm going to say add and next. There we go. We configured our external interface. Now this is our high availability network configuration. So we're going to do select existing VLAN. And we're going to go with internal. Remember, when we first set up our virtual appliance, we had to assign the WAN switch to the external interface, the LAN to the internal, and for the high availability, we selected internal. So there we go. Now, we want to leave everything else as is because this is the self IP address, 10.10.101.11. That's perfect. VLAN is internal, and it gave it this VLAN ID of 4094. It's fine, just perfect, and it already has the internal 1.2 interface applied to it. So we're going to click next. All right, time for NTP, your network time protocol configuration. So what you can do is come in here and add your own NTP servers if you want to, which you should do if you're in a production environment, because you want this device to use the same NTP servers as the rest of your devices. But since this is a lab, we're not going to set those up. But you could just put in your IP addresses there and then click the add button and they'll show up in here. And then there you go. So next. Now we come to DNS. So for your DNS servers, it does provide you with some defaults, which we're going to leave as default. But in your environment, if this is a production environment, of course, you're going to want to put your DNS servers in there, the same DNS servers the rest of your environment uses. You can also put in DNS search domain lists for your local domain you'd want to put in there, and any bind forward servers, you'd want to put those in there as well. Super. But we're going to leave this all as is and say next. Now, this is our config sync configuration, and we're not going to deal with this right now, so click next. And this is the management failover unicast setup, and that is our failover. That's our IP address of our local host, 10.10.101.11. This is for our high availability, and it's already pulled that information in, so we're just going to say next. Now, for a mirroring configuration, we don't deal with mirroring right now, so we're just going to say next because we're not using it yet. All right, there we go. And we have just finished up there, so let's go ahead and click our finish button down here. There we go. Super. And we are now finished with our base configuration. So let's go ahead and back this up. We're going to do an archive. So what we're going to do is we're going to click on system, and we're going to find archives, which is right here. So I clicked on archives, and it brought me into the archive list. And this is basically your backups. So what we want to do is go to create. There we go. We're going to give it a name. We're going to call this big IP1-base-config, because that's exactly what this is. It's our base configuration. You can enable encryption if you would like to and provide a passphrase. But since this is in lab, I'm not going to do that. But generally, you would definitely do this, okay? There we go. And your private keys, if you wanted to, you could include or exclude private keys. There we go. So all we're going to do is put in the name at this point. So I'm going to say finished. And right now, it's creating this archive for us. And again, an archive is just a backup of your configurations. And once it's finished saving, it's going to give us a notification here in a moment. And there it goes. So it says operation status. It says saving your active configuration. And it is saved. There we go. So we'll say OK. Super. And we can see we now have our big IP base 1 config.ucs. And that UCS is user configuration set. And that user configuration set is an archive that contains all the files that you're going to need to restore the current configuration to a new system. This is things like config files, licenses, accounts that were created, SSL certificates, like the whole shebang. It's in there. So now we're going to download a copy of this. So we have an offline copy of our backup or our archive. So I'm going to click on the archive name. There we go. It's going to take us in here. And now I'm going to come over here to the download button. I'm going to click on that. And there it goes. It has just downloaded that archive. So I now have a copy of my backups that I can store somewhere securely, of course. So there you go. That is walking through the base config of our F5 Big IP device. Now, in the next nugget, we're going to go ahead and set up our test host and verify connectivity. Thanks for watching, and subscribe here to get the latest from CBT Nuggets. And if you're interested in IT career or learning more about IT in general, hey, swing by cbtnuggets.com and sign up for a free trial.